Welcome to a tutorial how to build a desktop application for the Raspberry Pi with TMS Miletus. Just an outline for this video. I'm going to start to give you a few sentences about what is TMS Miletus, how you can get started with it. And then you're going to get exact steps how to migrate an existing TMS Web Core application to TMS Miletus. That will allow you to create a desktop application and deploy it to the Raspberry Pi. TMS Miletus is based on the TMS Web Core framework, meaning you can build a web application based on TMS Web Core, and it will allow you to deploy to Microsoft Windows, macOS, Linux, and now the Raspberry Pi. And the most amazing thing about all these platforms is that you can do this from your Delphi IDE. You don't have to start any applications on a macOS platform, the Linux platform, or on the Raspberry Pi platform. This also implies that you do not need the hardware. You only need your Windows PC with your Delphi IDE, and you can create software for all these other platforms. I can't emphasize this enough. So as a starting point for the demonstration, I'm going to use the contact form example that we've created in another demonstration I made. The contact form allows you to fill in user information and then send an email to you. It is published on YouTube, and to go there quickly, just use this QR code. This QR code, by the way, just as an aside, has been created with a TMS WXPack control to create QR codes, barcode, it includes a PDF viewer, and all other sorts of great components that are multi-platform. Have a look. But now back to TMS Miletus and how you can write software for the Raspberry Pi. Let's have a look at the starting point first. The web application uses index.html as the starting point, has one main form, and it also has a wrapper around the SMTP.js JavaScript package. It is configured for my own needs. It uses my personal code, so whenever I use this JavaScript library, it's going to send an email to my email address using the information provided in the form. The main form only consists of two buttons. One allows me to reset the information in the form, the other one sends the information, and then all the edit controls to take the information. Where does the design come from? Well, if you go to the HTML of the main form, you see that I created a Bootstrap layout, and all the controls, the TMS Web Core controls, are tied to these controls defined in the HTML using Bootstrap CSS. So the running application actually looks like this, even though at design time in the Delphi designer, it looks like this. That is the flexibility of TMS Web Core being able to tie existing Bootstrap layouts to TMS Web Core controls. You can fill out the information, click send, and let's see what send does. Send sends an email. Send email is tied to the TTMS.js wrapper. All of this is built in the other video I referenced on the slide. Please have a look there if that is something that interests you, how to build this with validation and everything that you can see right here. The focus of this video is about how to produce a desktop application based on this web application. So we create a new TMS Web Miletus application. It starts off showing the main form, and my advice is the first thing to do is save everything. I'm going to name the main form U form main. The starting point for the application is index.html, and the project itself I'm going to name contact form Miletus example. That's it. And now we can use the information provided from the other project directly. So we double click on the U form main HTML, select everything, remove everything, and now we copy the content from the other project into this HTML file. Obviously, there's a thousand ways to do this. I prefer Notepad++. Select everything, copy, switch over to Delphi, paste. And now the design for the main form is inside of our TMS Web Core, TMS Miletus project. Switching over to the form, there are no controls. So we right-click on the form surface, click Control Sync, and all the controls are being created so that our application uses the design and also has default controls for all the design elements. That means the reset button, the send button, the edit controls for the email, for the subject, for the body, for the first name, and for the last name, all of them are there. So at this point, looking at the build configuration, which is set to debug, we're able to run this. The result should be a Windows application because we're on a Windows system. And indeed it is. It already looks a little bit like the design. So what are the mistakes? Well, the mistake is that the form doesn't know that I wanted to use Bootstrap. So I close this, click on the form, and set the CSS library to CSS Bootstrap. Furthermore, for the element font, I make sure that it's set to EF CSS. At that point, I should be good to go. Recompile. There we go. It looks exactly like the web application just inside of a window. Don't mind the menu bar. This is just for debug purposes. The reason for that is I selected the debug. So if I want to get rid of the debug menu, I simply run in release mode, which also removes all the debug information from the application. So there we go. What is fascinating about the Miletus application is the fact that all the Bootstrap principles, when the display size changes, are kept. So right now we have two columns, and if the window becomes smaller, they're shown as stacked, just like a responsive web application would do. So the principles of Bootstrap and all the responsive design can be transferred to the desktop. That is a very, very powerful tool to have. So I click all the edit controls and remove the text. Of course, we could do this in code as well. Doing it design time is just much easier. Of course, the web memo, which is multi-line, doesn't have a text property. It has a lines property, which we can also edit easily using the IDE. So we go to the text property, remove. The disadvantage of this view is you can't really see which edit control this refers to. I'm quite sure TMS will make some modifications so that you can see the edit control inside here. So this little bit of cleanup improved the view even more. Let's recompile. And now we can even see the placeholders that are given in the HTML are no longer overwritten by the default values from TMS Web Core that are set in the text property. The buttons, they get their captions from the HTML as well. And also take note of the icons. So we are almost done. Of course, we haven't written any code yet. And that is something, again, we can copy paste from the existing web application. And I'm using copy paste, no magic, copy and paste. Just make sure that you keep the class registration for the form, which is something Miletus specific. And of course, I inserted for T form main. My form is called T form one. So let's rename it to form main. And everything should be in sync. Well, Control Shift C, and all the methods are defined. And we should be able to run this. Of course, the SMTP.js wrapper is still missing. And that file we can copy or reference, whatever you want to do. So I copied the file over. I can easily add it to the project, add and USMTP.js wrapper, done. That's it. Now we compile again. We get a failure, the regex. So we have to insert the libraries for that. That is in weblib regular expressions. Compile again. And compilation is successful. Before we run the application for the first time and check if the functionality is there, I would like to point something out. First, events. If you copy paste like I just did, the events have to be hooked up again. So the on-click event of both buttons have to be hooked up. You might wonder while seeing this, why I didn't simply copy over the Pascal files from the other project and made the modifications. Well, there is a video where I show a migration that way. This time, I wanted to show a building approach where you build based on a new TMS Miletus form and add existing functionality. Both approaches are valid, and this is an alternative, and you can decide which one of the two alternatives you want to choose, which gets you where you want to be faster. That is something you can decide. Also, there's one more pitfall with regards to external JavaScript libraries. I use the SMTP JavaScript library, and it has to be referenced inside of your HTML code. You have two possible options where to do this, and in this case, I did it in the index.html file. So you need to update the index.html file from the existing web application as well, just copying the reference to the frameworks that you use. Just be aware that there might be references in the specific form as well, depending on how you designed it. As you will copy the HTML and CSS from the forms, no matter what, it might be a good point to place those references there and not in the index.html file. However, in this case, it has to be the index.html file, otherwise the name isn't available and you might encounter an error message as soon as you click send and want to use the framework. Test subject, test message, and send. And OK, success. So I'm monitoring my email on the right. So as soon as the email comes in, I'll be able to present it to you. And there is the email from hflake@me.com to my address, test message. And of course, the message wasn't digitally signed or anything fancy. So there is no verification possible, but the test subject, everything is as we entered. So it works. Also, the clear button works. At this point, we are able to create applications for all the platforms listed in the build configuration. So let's do this for Raspberry Pi, a release version. So build Raspberry Pi, compile, and that's it. I right click, go to the Show in Explorer feature, go to the TMS web folder, and there are the files for the Raspberry Pi. This is the executable, and this is for the desktop link. I'll now copy the files to the Raspberry Pi in my network and start the file from there. Here's my Raspberry Pi system using a VNC connection, and I'll copy the files over now from the network. So using the file manager, there are my files on the network. I select copy. Here's a folder on my Raspberry Pi with some test files. I erase those and replace. Of course, double clicking this doesn't do anything because the file has to be given executable rights. So right click, properties, permissions, execute, anyone, and double click, execute. Let's see what happens. And there it is, our application, full desktop application, only one file, one executable, and it is the same application as we had as a web application that we can deploy with TMS Miletus to any of the platforms that are supported. This is how easy it is to deploy desktop applications to Windows, macOS, Linux, and now the Raspberry Pi. For more information about TMS Miletus and TMS WebCore, go to web.tmssoftware.com.